Sitting on the dais, our Honorable Director, Professor Rajiv Sangalji. The speaker for the day, Professor Arun Tiwari ji. Senior colleagues of mine among the audience, Professor GVS Sastri, Professor R.S. Singh, Professor K.K. Singh, and the great person from Hyderabad who has come all the way from Hyderabad just to listen this beautiful lecture to be delivered by Professor Tiwari. Yes, they are very junior colleagues, senior colleagues, Professor Jha, and my young friends, ladies and gentlemen. It's my proud privilege to welcome you all to this very lecture itself. I welcome you on my personal behalf, also on the behalf of whole ILS team, Institute Lecture Series team. The Institute Lecture Series, the under this kind of banner, why the Institute Lecture was thought of, yes, within the department and within the school, we do conduct many special lectures, and those lectures are basically thematic around a typical topic itself. We listen to the voice of the people. Over here, when we come for the Institute Lecture Series, we cut across this kind of discipline and we try to understand the general philosophy. And when we talk about the general philosophy, it loses its relevance with a particular discipline and we live with a broader aspect of something. And with this kind of vision, when we conceive of Institute Lecture Series, we do not limit ourselves only to science and technology. Yes, we do address science and technology, but we also cover maybe topics related to economics, social sciences. Yes, sir. Yes. So I was talking, maybe what kind of topics do we take, particularly under Institute Lecture Series itself. So we also talk about values, ethics, philosophy, maybe you name it and we have it. Only thing is that, yes, maybe the lecture should address the basic philosophy of any subject. And the purpose of having it, why is that we go for such kind of Institute Lecture Series? The purpose is to impart the education, and this education should finally lead to innovation. And innovation should ultimately lead to some kind of change. Change, not any kind of change. Change which has some positive sense. So with this brief introduction, and I call upon Professor R.S. Singh ji to kindly introduce the speaker for the day, Professor Arun Tiwari ji. Professor R.S. Singh.
Thank you, sir. Very good evening to all of you. I have given opportunity to introduce today's speaker, and I am very thankful for this to Professor Agrawal and Professor Sharma. I am privileged to introduce the famous scientist and writer, Professor Arun Tiwari, who will deliver 32nd lecture of Institute Lecture Series. Professor Arun Tiwari was born at Meerut, Uttar Pradesh in 1955. He did his master's in mechanical engineering from GB Pant University and joined Defense Research Development Laboratory, DRDL, Hyderabad, as missile scientist in 1982 and reported to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. At DRDL, Professor Tiwari developed India's first titanium air bottle used in Trishul and Akash missile and designed air frames for both missiles. In 1992, on becoming chief of DRDO, Dr. Kalam decided to develop civilian spin-offs of defense technology to provide benefit of investment in defense technology to common people of India, and appointed Professor Tiwari as program director. In 1996, Professor Tiwari developed India's first coronary stent with cardiologist Dr. B. Soma Raju, and known as Kalam Raju stent. So this is a great contribution of Professor Tiwari. And this led to creation of CARE Foundation and later the CARE Hospitals. So again, he has contribution in the area of science and technology as well as in the social fields. As a member of President Kalam's team, Professor Tiwari set up first link of Pan-Africa e-network and now connects universities and hospitals across the African continent with their Indian counterparts. In 1999, Professor Tiwari wrote Wings of Fire, an autobiography of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. The book becomes a modern classic with 52 reprints and selling more than 2 million copies. This is again great achievement. Of it translated into 12 Indian and 6 foreign languages. He has written 12 books after that, and since then his latest book, Transcendence with Dr. Kalam and APJ Abdul Kalam A Life, are the current bestsellers. Professor Tiwari is a Platinum Jubilee Mentor of CSIR, Indian Institute of Chemical Technology, Hyderabad, Director Care Foundation, Hyderabad, and teaches at School of Management Science in Hyderabad University as adjunct professor at present. We are privileged and fortunate to have such an eminent person with us today, and now I invite Professor Tiwari to deliver the lecture. Thank you.
Yes, we are definitely going to have his lecture itself, but before that, we are going to have a very, very important event. And for that purpose, I call upon even Vijay Saiji to be here on the dais. I request you to please come from the other side and take your seat on the dais, please. See, it's like this. We are going through a very, very, just now, maybe within few seconds itself, we are going to pass by a very historical moment. You have already heard about the books written, a book on Wings of Fire written by Professor Tiwari itself, and has written wonderful book on commentary on Gita, which comes as Gita Rahasya, commentary written by Lokman Tilak. And we are going to witness the release of this very book itself right today. I call upon the dignitaries of the dais to please release this book right today, please. Seize this opportunity to request our honorable director to get few copies of this book, particularly for our library itself, and will be immensely benefited from the write-up. I remember, like maybe your books are Professor Tiwari, Wings of Fire. My wife doesn't read such kind of book and hates the book written in English, but she was the lady who could purchase that book and read right from first page to the last page. And if you ask her, he can narrate many of the things. So I'm pretty sure that this book is also going to be very interesting, and we are going to be immensely benefited with the content whatever we find in this book. Now, maybe formally, I invite Professor Tiwari ji to share his experiences with all of us.
Respected Professor Sangal, Agarwal Vaisa, friends, and my friend Mr. Vijay Sai, who has flown in from Hyderabad for this lecture. The lecture is important because the place is important. This is a sacred place, and is a great fortune to come here. I did my engineering. I never had the fortune of, I'm not that brilliant, and to get into IIT. So whenever I come to IIT, I feel good. So today, speaking at IIT itself is a great moment for me. My father is no more. He left very early. In his heaven, he must be smiling ki banda pahunch gaya kaise bhi. So, this is my third visit to this place. First time I came with President Kalam. From Babatpur, we flew in Air Force helicopters, and we landed up in BHU. It was BHU convocation. A second time I came for the first convocation of IIT. Professor Sangal was there, and this is the third time, but I'm not coming alone. I'm bringing Dr. Kalam with me. So this time also, he's very much there. Now, I briefly tell you, it's very easy to say that I worked with Dr. Kalam, but then in what capacity we worked, because we are all born in families, and many times we can't even learn from our parents. Although we live with them. So many times we live together, but we don't learn anything. So it's very important to understand what is the meaning of spending 33 years with Dr. Kalam. I want to tell you very clearly that I am 63 years old. That means more than 50% of my life I spent with him. First, in 1982, I joined the Defense Research and Development Laboratory, which make missiles, and worked there directly under him. So he was my boss. So boss means director, and there is a big difference. Only he can inspire you. Beyond that, personal interaction is not possible most of the time. But he gave me an opportunity to do something path-breaking, that is titanium air bottle, and I successfully completed it. And in that process, I landed up in Aerospatial France and to test these air bottles. And I become pretty famous in the early age. So it's all blessings. He decided to do something good for the ordinary people of this country from the money which comes into defense, nuclear energy, and space. So he said, see, this is the thought. His heart was always beating for the ordinary people of India. So he raised this question, what we can do for the ordinary people of India from this money. And he gave me the task of interacting with doctors, and we successfully made a coronary stent. Then he became the president of India, and for 5 years I worked as a physician team member. I saw my entire country, and many countries I visited with him. And in that process met the leaders, Nobel laureates, big people, Mr. Putin, Mr. Bush. And we realized, oh, humare jaise hi hain sab log. They're all people like us only. So this is one great learning I got working with Dr. Kalam, that we, Mr. Bill Gates, all these people, because they used to come to meet Dr. Kalam, so we also get an opportunity to shake hands with them and all that. And then we realize that they are also human beings like us only. Sabki do aankh hain, sabka ye do kaan hain. So kya hai? What is that difference which differentiate between people? That question came to my mind. So we co-authored together 5 books, 99 Wings of Fire, Guiding Souls 2004, You Are Born to Blossom 2006, Squaring the Circle 2013, and Transcendence in 2015. And you can see from the title of the books itself that it was a spiritual journey. We are trying to find out what is that? What is that which differentiate between an ordinary person and a great person? So this whole books, the title itself are like that. And I have deliberately choose this peacock feather in every slide, because this peacock feather, you know why it is so beautiful, why it has so many shades, mysterious, because its entire structure is nanotextured. There's a very intricate nano-sized grid on the surface of the feather that gives its brilliance. So peacock, and why Lord Krishna used to have peacock, there is some innate understanding which tell you that this is the highest level of technology. So when we talk about nanotechnology and nano is equal to 10 to the power minus 9, that's very childish. Because in not my lifetime, your lifetime, we'll be going to pico and femito and all that, and life will be very different at that place. So it is just trying to know what exists cannot be said as knowledge. To be known is a very, very vast thing in front of us. So the wish to know that, the desire to know that, I think that differentiates between ordinary people and big people. So with this I take off, and I'm very sure that those of you who could make it to come here, and Mr. Vijay, he is also listening to my lecture first time, although he's coming from Hyderabad. So maybe it was destined that this lecture I talk at you here in Banaras Hindu University. God has his own designs. So starting from Wings of Fire, it is divided into four parts: orientation, creation, propitiation, and contemplation. Actually, all our life is divided into four parts only. But unfortunately, some of us are stuck on orientation only. Even when they are 60-year-old, they are not oriented. They say, kya hai life? Extension kab milega? 60 years ke baad extension dhoondte firte hain. 60 years mein kuch nahi hua, extension karke kya ho jayega? They are so blind to the reality outside that they thought that their careers itself is the reality. So those are aur bada lete hain usme. So the point is, many of people at the age of 60, 70, 80 also are not oriented, and they waste this life and go as disoriented people. Many, many, not one or two. The second thing is creation. Very few persons got this opportunity to create something. Very few. It's a blessing. Otherwise, so the maximum we create is wo khana bana liya, fridge khareed liya, AC lagwa liya, carpet khareed liya. Aur kya create karte hain? We don't create anything. Then comes propitiation. Some people are blessed to create institutions and go beyond them. Madan Mohan Malviya ji, he created this entire institution. और लोगों से इंस्टीट्यूशन बने बनाए चलते नहीं हैं, अब ऐसी हालत आ गई है. सो फाइनली कंटेम्पलेशन, यू लुक बैक एंड रियलाइज व्हाट दिस लाइफ इज ऑल अबाउट एंड देन मर्ज विद इटर्निटी. सो आई विल डिसाइड डिवाइड दिस लेक्चर इनटू एग्जैक्टली फोर पार्ट्स. द फर्स्ट इज ओरिएंटेशन. डॉक्टर कलाम वॉज बॉर्न इन 15th October 1931 इन रामेश्वरम. He got his schooling from a Christian school, and only schools available at those times were Christian schools only. And the whole challenge was making Banaras Hindu University was that his education has to be, the fees of the education is my religion. Because the whole idea was, convert to us, then we'll teach you. So this visionary, he thought this is too much of a fees. So he took upon himself, हमारी यूनिवर्सिटी हम बनाएंगे. एंड देन ही इनवाइटेड डॉक्टर राधाकृष्णन हु वॉज ए सर एट दैट टाइम 1931 ही गॉट द नाइटहुड एंड ही वॉज टीचिंग ही वॉज ए फुल प्रोफेसर इन ऑक्सफोर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी. ही इन्वाइटेड हिम टू कम इन 1936 एंड बिकम द वाइस चांसलर ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्सिटी. एंड ही वॉज द वाइस चांसलर यूनिवर्सिटी फॉर लॉन्ग 10 ईयर्स. एंड ऑल ऑफ हिम वॉज बी नोइंग दैट इन 1942 ऑन सिल्वर जुबली ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्सिटी ही इन्वाइटेड महात्मा गांधी एज द चीफ गेस्ट. And he gave honorary doctorate to Jawaharlal Nehru and Babu Rajendra Prasad. It infuriated Britishers to such an extent that when he got their first opportunity in August 1942, army entered into BHU campus and they declared that BHU is closed. There is no more BHU. It will be the Banaras cantonment. Then Dr. Radhakrishnan took a train, went to Delhi, tried to meet the Vasaraya. And Vasaraya says, you are a vice chancellor, I am a Vasaraya, how can I meet you? Somebody told him that he is not only a vice chancellor, he is also Sir Radhakrishnan, knighted by King George. So maybe without meeting him, you are insulting the king. So then he realized, ye toh job ka sawal hai, sab log job se darte hain. So chalo mil lete hain. So he gave 10 minutes to Dr. Radhakrishnan. Dr. Radhakrishnan, you know Dr. Radhakrishnan, Dr. Radhakrishnan. With his turban and all, when you walk, I mean, he is like a king, Chakravarti. So he entered there, and the first question he asked to the Viceroy, which school you are graduated from? And he knew very well that wo army ka aadmi hai, wo university wagera nahi gaya wo. So he says, no, I did not go to a university. Ah, that is why you don't know the importance of university. That is why you have closed it. Those who do not go to university, how do they know what is the importance of the university? And then he asked him that these 5,000 students, that time only 5,000 students were there, but 1942, 5,000 students is also a great number. So you have thrown their luggage and trunks and bed seats outside the campus. Now who will stop them in becoming krantikaris and terrorists? Tell me. You are serving the Vasaraya, or you are serving the crown, or you are destroying the crown. And then you took 1 hour class. So when we celebrate his birthday as a teacher's day, it is not just like that. I think that is the most authentic birthday we celebrate. He was a true teacher. BHU was the only university in 1942 in India. There were 7-8 universities only, but BHU was the only university which did not lose the academic year for the students. Bharat Chodo Andolan bhi chalta raha, aur academic year bhi pura hua. Extra class lagi, sab kuch hua. So this love. And another, sir, it is a very small thing, but I must tell that in 1954, the first lot of Bharat Ratna was awarded. So C.V. Raman was there, Dr. Radhakrishnan was there. Now, Babu Rajendra Prasad wrote a letter to C.V. Raman, sir, please come and stay in Rashtrapati Bhavan for 3 days, 27, to participate in Republic Day Parade and stay. 30th is the function for Bharat Ratna. Please receive the Bharat Ratna. C.V. Raman has written, I saw that letter in the archive of Rashtrapati Bhavan. He has written, I am guiding my students' PhD. It is in the final stage. His viva is there on 31st. It is not proper for me to accept your invitation. Thank you very much for your grace. So we are born in this country. It's not a small country. There is something great in this place. So when I find coming here, Dr. Radhakrishnan, C.V. Raman, everybody is here. So this is the Punya Chetra, and all of you are blessed that you are here. All of you are blessed. You have to understand that what do I do? Now that I am already blessed, deal is there, I have accepted the blessedness. What do I give back for this? That is the issue. So if this lecture can start that thought process in you, I think I have done my job. So he went to St. Joseph College, Trichy. Then he did his PG diploma in aeronautical engineering. And again, one very important point here, there were no IITs at that time. And education was only paid education, except BHU. Everywhere you have to pay. And Madras Institute of Technology, sadly, this fees was very high. So how a ordinary and poor person, Dr. Kalam, can get education? His elder sister, Zora, they are total five siblings. Number two is sister, four brothers. Everybody died except the eldest brother. She gave her gold bangles as the admission fee for Dr. Kalam. Now tell me how many ladies can give their gold bangles to finance their younger brother's education after marriage? Pura lafda ho jayega. Mother-in-law, everybody will come. Shadi ho gayi, wo alag ghar hai, alag ghar hai. So this is the, these are the things, these are the sacrifices. These are the sacrifices, these are the things. These, we should know that. That like this only Abdul Kalams are made. Then he joined as senior scientific assistant at DTDNP Air at a great salary of 250 rupees. And aeronautical development establishment started in Bangalore, and then they recruited him, and then he joined that place. So up to 1963, that means 31 to 63, 32-year-old, Dr. Kalam is a nobody. That's all. So all of you, how many of you are less than 32? So don't worry. You are a nobody only, na? No problem. Because up to the age of 32, Dr. Kalam was a nobody. Kuch nahi hua unke life mein. But then, ek aam ka beech lagate hain, wo itna bada ped hota hai, to koi to yehi nahi pata hota hai aam ka ped hai. If somebody is from villages and he knows, wo, at least he can recognize aam ka ped hai. But fal ki tak kab aata hai? After 10 years it comes. Then there is a season when it comes. So I can see many Kalams sitting here. And Kalam is not a masculine thing. It is any female Kalam. This girl can be Abdul Kalam. So it is transformation. So you are less than 32, but you can be a Kalam, because at this age of 32, even he was a nobody. So now we go deeper into the lecture. What is that which makes a nobody as somebody? And from that body, that we discuss about him after he has left also. So Swami Vivekananda said, he on whom God's grace descends in a moment goes beyond all laws. Laws means wo ye GPA hai, uske baad campus recruitment hai, ye to laws hai, postdoctorate hai, ye sab laws hai. But jiske upar grace padta hai, wo uski life mein kuch bhi ho sakta hai. All these laws don't apply on him. आई एम गिविंग ए लेक्चर हियर और इससे ज़्यादा क्या ग्रेस हो सकता है. आई मीन आई कांट बिलीव दैट आई एम स्पीकिंग इन आईआईटी. सो दिस इज ग्रेस. नो एंटाइटलमेंट इट इज गिवन. सो हाउ डू आई गेट इट? Isn't it that question comes to you also, how do I get it? So at the end of the lecture I will ask you and all you will tell that yes, I know how to get it now. So be careful. Another 20 minutes, lot of things you are going to learn. So the first grace comes when government of India decide that let us start space research. Now is nothing to do with Dr. Kalam. So many decisions are being taken. You have nothing to do with you. But somewhere there is a bigger plan going on where you will go and plug in, that's all, without your knowledge also. So in that process, they found out how many aeronautical engineers are working in the country. There were no computers. So 10-15 din mein sabke yahan se, some 30-35 people were there. So sabko appointment letter chala gaya. Many refused. Ye achha hai, kahe ko jaane ka hai. Why do we join the new organization? It will happen, it will not happen. But there are some people who, Dr. Kalam was one of them, he says, is an opportunity, let me grab it. Darna nahi. Don't be scared of unknown. Don't be too much attached to what you are already having. Go to the unknown. So he went to the unknown, and within 3 months, he was sent to NASA, where he spent about March to December, about 9 years he spent at 3 premier institutions, and that is where he realized that there is a lot which is to be done in our country. You have to go out of the country to understand what is to be done. अभी तो यही discussion हो रहा है कि खुले में शौच करना ठीक नहीं है. तो government तो शौचालय बनवा सकती है, आप उसमें अपनी बकरी बांध दो, उसको कोई थोड़ी रोक सकता है. So we are, you know, from that stage. How much distance we have to cover? How much distance we have to cover? This is the picture of Dr. Kalam, second from left, and perfect gentleman. Baal baal kate hue hai abhi. So at some point of time they will start growing. I will tell you when that stage will come. So abhi to theek hai. You are also all right. Now he came back and he started. Indian Space Research Organization. Look at the picture. Who is carrying this nose cone on the cycle? That is how life started. That is how ISRO started. आजकल नया फैशन चल गया, ये नहीं है, वो नहीं है, एसी नहीं है, पर्दा नहीं है, कुर्सी नहीं है. अरे इस सब के लिए काम थोड़ी शुरू होता है. काम करना शुरू करो. जब काम करना शुरू करोगे सब आ जाएगा. So we are totally reverse the whole thing. We want everything before we start work. But then life does not move like that. You start work like this. You start work like that. No assistant, no peon, no chaprasi. That is how life moves. Then this is the India's first filament winding machine. Now the beauty of game is, you are all working in Indian Institute of Technology. Technology is very non-glamorous kind of a job. उसमें कोई glamour नहीं है, MBA वाला glamour नहीं है उसमें. कोई 25 लाख का 50 लाख का पैकेज नहीं देता आके यहाँ पे. क्या हो तुम, इंजीनियर हो, कौन सी ब्रांच है, ऐसे बोलते हैं. Now the point I am trying to make it here is, this world moves on technology. And whenever you see something big happening, then you will see the infusion of technology in the country. Now bullet train will come. With bullet train, oh my God, a quantum jump will come from this technology level to that technology. Everything in railways is going to change. So when they were making the satellite launch vehicle, the first thing is FRP, fiber reinforced plastic, as you used to call it. So filament winding machine, composite. So Dr. Kalam started his career, he is the first composite engineer of the country. And the gentleman looking at him is Vikram Sarabhai, as you all know. And this gentleman at the corner, this innocent looking young boy, is Madhavan Nair, who later became the chairman of ISRO. So once again, I'm telling you, with all somebodies, there are nobodies. And 20 years from now, these somebodies will not be there, and they will be remembered for those nobodies who will be somebodies at that point of time. That's all life is all about. Now, hairs have become a little stylish, because by this time, satellite launch vehicle is already launched. Other gentleman is Satish Dhawan sir, and they are meeting Prime Minister Gandhi to tell her that satellite launch vehicle is successful and Rohini satellite is orbiting around the Earth. It's a great success. In this picture, look at the eyes of Dr. Kalam. This fearlessness, this indifference, Prime Minister hi to na. तो मैं कोई आईएएस थोड़ी हूँ जो मैं धूम लाऊंगा. मैं तो साइंटिस्ट हूँ, मेरे को क्या लेना देना है आपसे. सो व्हेन यू स्टार्ट लुकिंग एट द पर्संस ऑफ अथॉरिटी पॉलिटिशियंस एंड ऑल दैट विद दैट कॉन्फिडेंस, आई थिंक दैट इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ट्रेनिंग विच मेक्स यू डिफरेंट देन द अदर ब्रांचेस. आप एमबीए थोड़ी हो जो बैलेंस शीट को मैनिपुलेट कर दोगे. यू आर गवर्न्ड बाय सम लॉज. That's all. When you multiply two matrix, if all the diagonal of the matrix is not zero, then it won't move. आपका तो बूलियन अलजेब्रा है, उसमें तो वन जीरो वन जीरो. लाइफ बहुत स्ट्रेट है या तो नहीं है. वी आर नॉट शेक्सपियर हियर टू बी और नॉट टू बी. वी आर हियर आइदर वी आर देयर और वी आर नॉट देयर. दैट्स ऑल. सो बी प्राउड ऑफ दैट क्लैरिटी इन योर लाइफ. बी प्राउड ऑफ दैट that absolute no nonsense in life, and that is only technology. Technology do not fudge, technology does not market, technology does not overstate and all that. Technology is technology, either it is or it is not. That's all. Then comes the second grace and a chance meeting with Dr. Raja Ramanna. Now why I am calling it as a grace? Because, see, we take things for granted. We think only those things which we do are important. जैसे मैं यहाँ आके मैं lecture दे रहा हूँ, I am thinking I am doing some very important work. Some of you have come here, you are thinking is there some important thing we are attending. Some people have not come, they are very sure that they are doing more important work than this lecture. They are 100% sure. कोई सो रहा होगा, कोई टीवी के सामने बैठा होगा. Okay, वो importance है उनकी life में. So the point is, there is nothing chance in this world. Neither my coming here is a chance, nor Vijay Sai coming here is a chance, nor your sitting here is a chance. There is no chance in this world. This world does not move on chance. This world moves on a very, very deep design. These algorithms are beyond the comprehension of human being because they encompass so many layers of reality. Already people are talking about multi-universe and all these things, mathematics, something, but anyway, we are not, without going into that, even the lifetimes. Today I spend 1 hour going from Asigarh to Dashashmeh Ghat. Everything is happening there. Cremation is also happening there. Marriage is also happening there. Now puja is also happening there. Mundan Sanskar is also happening there. Whole life you can see in this 1 hour. So this is not an ordinary place. So this meeting, chance meeting, he went to that function and they were just sitting together. And Raja Ramanna told him, why don't you come to DRDO? You have flown already satellite not vehicle. Hamare yahan koi missile banai nahi aaj tak. The organization is existing for last 20 years delivering nothing. So why don't you come? And he came. Now people call Dr. Kalam is the father of guided missile program of India. But how he entered into missile? Because of a chance meeting. So, ये चांस मीटिंग को लाइटली मत लेना भैया कभी भी. दी चांस मीटिंग्स आर ओनली द इंपॉर्टेंट टर्निंग पॉइंट्स ऑफ योर लाइफ. ओके, चांस मीटिंग, बिकॉज व्हाट यू डिजाइन, यू डिजाइन. गॉड इज नॉट रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दैट, बट व्हाट हैपेंस टू यू दैट इज वेरी डेफिनेट. एंड यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल इन अटेंडिंग टू what is happening to you rather than what you want to happen on the outside, because this world was existing earlier before you arrived here. It will continue to exist after your departure also. The issue is what for you were born and what you can do. That deal, if you understand, then the whole machinery will start functioning very efficiently and fast. So you can see that in 1985, this picture shows Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi and N.T. Rama Rao, and in 1985, foundation stone is laid, and 1988, the world-class missile assembly complex called Research Center Imarat is inaugurated. 3 years, that's all. Now you can see that the whole style in which Dr. Kalam is standing behind the Prime Minister and the Chief Minister, that makes him different. He is not subservient. He is not standing like this. अभी तो आजकल लोग सीधे भी खड़े नहीं होते पॉलिटिशियन के सामने, ऐसे करके खड़े होते हैं. I mean, it's not acceptable. You have to be Radhakrishna. Which university you have gone? And your politician says, मैं 10th pass भी नहीं हूँ. हाँ, very good. तो गाय का निबंध लिखना भी नहीं आता. No, गाय का निबंध, don't take it lightly. Because we were all taught English. Cow is a domestic animal. It has 4 legs and 2 horns and 1 tail. Nobody told us that वो गाय के 4 थन होते हैं. तो हमें अभी भी नहीं पता वो 4 थन की इंग्लिश क्या होती है. वो स्कूल में नहीं पढ़ाई किसी ने, तो अभी तक भी नहीं पढ़ी. वी डोंट नो. सो काउ ऐसे इज ऑल्सो नॉट, एवरीबडी इज टॉकिंग अबाउट काउ. उससे पूछो थन की इंग्लिश क्या होती है, नहीं वो नहीं पता मेरे को. सो दिस इज द सिचुएशन वी आर इन. दिस इज द सिचुएशन वी आर इन. डोंट टेक योर एजुकेशन लाइटली. आज जो मिस हो गया वो हमेशा के लिए मिस हो गया, दोबारा चांस नहीं आएगा. Now this is the successful launch of Agni missile on 22nd May 1989. Scientists are carrying Dr. Kalam on their shoulders, and this gentleman, he is Mr. V.S. Saraswat, now the Niti Aayog member for strategic technologies. But why I want to show this slide is that the ultimate honor is when your juniors carry you on their shoulders. That's all. Life is all about that, sir. जब आपके चेले आपको अपने कंधे पे बिठा के घुमाएं, उससे बड़ा कोई ऑनर इस लाइफ में नहीं है. नो पद्मा अवार्ड, नो नथिंग, नथिंग इज ऑल, वो सब गिव एंड टेक कहानी है. बट योर स्टूडेंट शुड टेक केयर, योर जूनियर शुड टेक केयर ऑन योर शोल्डर्स. दैट इज अल्टीमेट ऑनर एनीबडी कैन गेट, एंड डॉक्टर कलाम गॉट दैट ऑनर. Then everybody knows that we very successfully conducted the nuclear test in 1998. May 96, and this gentleman on the left in military fatigue is, his name was Major General Prithvi Raj, because Abdul Kalam name should not come on telephone. So he was named as Major General Prithvi Raj, and he wore this dress. Why Prithvi Raj? Because he made Prithvi missile, so uska naam kya hona chahiye? Prithvi Raj. Now more interesting thing is, what was the name of Mr. Chidambaram who is sitting with him, Chairman Atomic Commission? His name was Nataraj. तो भैया हमारा भी कोड है, जैसे गौरी मोहम्मद के कोड है, हमारा भी कोड है. आपको नहीं आता तो हम क्या करें? सो चिदम्बरम का नाम क्या हो सकता है? नटराज हो सकता है. कलाम का नाम क्या हो सकता है? पृथ्वीराज हो सकता है. वेरी सिंपल, वी आर टॉकिंग लॉजिक. आप कह रहे हो सीक्रेट लैंग्वेज में बात कर रहे हो. वी आर ओनली टॉकिंग सिंपल थिंग्स. देन यू गॉट भारत रत्न आफ्टर सी वी रामन. He is the second scientist to get Bharat Ratna. Long gap. Then something very interesting. This photograph is taken on 4th January 2001. Light combat aircraft LCA flown. And Air Marshal Chitnis, Dr. Kalam, Kotari Narayana, George Fernandes. Now, do you wonder that this news item, it is December 2017. Why one machine which you have made in 2001, you are not allowing it to be made in the country? And if machine is useless, why it should be made now? 60,000 crores order given by government to an Indian company, how much, where this money will go? To people, to IITians, to regional college, bichare jo gareeb log hai. May I come in, sir, I'm a mechanical engineer, that's all. Wo plumbing bhi kar sakta hun. That is the situation we have landed ourselves. This 60,000 is going to go, 60,000 crores is going to go to these people. Factories banengi, auto khade hoenge, vade pav banenge uske bahar. Kuch to desh mein khushiyali aayegi. Now if you don't allow it to happen, then the whole edifice of the technical education, scientific education become bogus. It becomes a cheating. Then what for you are admitting students? Why you are asking the why? Sapne kyon dikha rahe ho unko? Aur dikha rahe ho to unko job dene ke liye paisa kyon nahi laga rahe? So first time situation is changing. This one slide shows that story has changed. Now LCA will fly. 32 planes are already in air. Even lady pilots are flying them. And nobody can stop from LCA. Now there is no question on LCA. It's the best aircraft in the situation. हमें कोई 5000 किलोमीटर थोड़ी लड़ना है. हमारा तो जो दुश्मन है वो हमारी बगल में बैठा हुआ है. हमारे को तो कोई ऐसा एयरक्राफ्ट चाहिए जो उसको ऐसे ही मार दे बस. We don't need some big plane and all these things. We need a good plane. What NET has done in 1965, everybody knows. Now you are not allowing that plane to be made. So LCA is a great technology demonstrator. And again, I want to tell you, if you look at the tail, it is written even today, KH. K for Kalam, H for Hari Narayana. This country know how to respect their good people. Yes, Kodari Narayana. So this country knows how to respect its people. It knows. Now third grace. Now this picture is a beautiful picture. Now you must be knowing all of them. Because that is they are shown every day on TV. The beauty of this picture is, the occasion is Dr. Kalam filing the nomination for the President of India. How Dr. Kalam can become President of India? Is grace. There is no entitlement, there is no equation. There is no algorithm which give you a result of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam except grace. Now if you see, the beauty of this picture is you can see Benji also, you can see Netaji also, you can see Mark Darshak also. This gentleman, he was at Sri Devi funeral also recently, Amar Singh Saab. And everybody is there. Madam is also there. Now the beauty of this picture is, इस दिन के पहले कभी ये लोग एक रूम में नहीं बैठे, इस दिन के बाद भी कभी एक रूम में नहीं बैठे. It was only that day that they were sitting together, and after that they never sat together. आज आप ये मीटिंग करा के दिखा दो, it will be impossible. किसी का पेट खराब हो जाएगा, किसी की फ्लाइट मिस हो जाएगी, नहीं आएंगे वहाँ पर, very difficult. So he became the president of India. And when he became President of India, he used that office for best of the purpose. He invited all the fire tender firemen to Rashtrapati Bhavan. One delegation came. Postmen he invited. Some 200 postmen. So many of them were crying. Sir, hum to dakiya hain, hame Rashtrapati Bhavan mein kabhi aayenge, humne socha bhi nahi tha. He invited nurses. These people, these faceless people who are the actual driver of the society. आप फायरमैन को निकाल दो, पोस्टमैन को निकाल दो, नर्स को निकाल दो, देन यू सी व्हाट विल हैपन. किसान को निकाल दो. सो ही इनवाइटेड ऑल ऑफ देम. नाउ इन दैट प्रोसेस वी वेंट टू साउथ अफ्रीका, वी मेट नेल्सन मंडेला. आई वाज आल्सो सिटिंग इन वन कॉर्नर. नाउ इन इंडिया वी हैव ए कल्चरल प्रॉब्लम. दैट कल्चरल प्रॉब्लम इज वेन एवर वी विजिट समबडी, अच्छा खासा मीटिंग हो जाता है, वो चलते समय वी यूज सम एक्स्ट्रा वर्ड. And seniors know very well that what it can do. Sasural jate samay particularly, chalte samay koi baat muh se nikal jati hai, and then it becomes a mess. So young people also, be very careful because it is a cultural problem. Jyada bolne ki aadat hai hamare yahan. Wo bhi achha khasa meeting ho gaya, puri deal final ho gayi. Last mein you will say something stupid and something goes wrong. So this meeting went off very well, and we were very happy that everything is going as per script. So now Dr. Kalam has to get up and get out, all of us. Now Dr. Kalam suddenly says, out of the script, Mr. Mandela. And then humne socha ho gaya abhi now. Jo hona tha wo hoga abhi. We can't stop him. See, what message I can take for Indian people from you. Now this was not in the script. So Nelson Mandela is a very charming person, Amitabh Bachchan, very baritone voice and all that. So he gave a hearty laugh, ha 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 ha, like that. Then what he said is, I will never forget. He says, sir, you sent a barrister to our country and we converted into a Mahatma. We sent a Mahatma to you and you guys killed him. आप तो बड़े लोग हो, हम आपको क्या दे सकते हैं? Look at the way others look at you. A country he became from barrister to Mahatma Gandhi, and his own country he was assassinated. Father of the nation assassinated. कितनी अच्छी न्यूज़ है. So you learn all these things once you go out and look how others are looking at you. So this is a beautiful picture which carry a lot of a big bundle of memories in my mind. On another occasion, we met President Musharraf, and Dr. Kalam told him, "Bhai sahab, ye 100 saal ke liye chhod do na abhi. Kuch aur kaam karte hain, hospital banate hain. Kuch to karo. Achhe hospital banate hain, kheti ka kaam shuru karte hain. Kashmir 100 saal ke liye postpone kar dete hain. 100 saal ke baad jo hoega, wo apne aap usko sort out kar lega." What a beautiful thought. But then anyway, like all beautiful thought, this thought also was not accepted. Then he went to Russia and he visited the aerospace scientist. So he always remained a scientist. What I am going to tell you here is that whatever he has become, he always remained an engineer to the core. He has the wisdom of sitting through a big PowerPoint presentation and doing like this, and he says, nahi nahi, 3.5 specific missiles to kam hai. 4 se kam mein missile nahi udega. Now, this is what is called wisdom. Wo calculator nahi chahiye usko. They have something which tell them that it will work and it will not work. And that comes from when you are totally immersed into your field. Then comes to the final part called emancipation. He is Pramukh Swamiji Maharaj, the chief of BAPS Akshar Purushottam Sanstha, who made beautiful Akshardham in Delhi. And we wrote a book together called Transcendence. And he allowed me to speak about the book. How many professors they allow their students to speak about the work they are doing? Now this is something which is so special about him. So for me, this is the proudest moment. I am speaking in front of two great people and they are looking at me what I am talking. So these moments are the priceless moments of your life. Nothing can exceed these moments. Now I come to a very important part. This book was released, this picture is from the release of this function. The date is 20th June 2015. In that book, on page number 50, Dr. Kalam writes, I am in a God synchronous orbit now. I am a God synchronous orbit now. Look at the English, satellite man, Tata Sky, geosynchronous orbit. So he will speak his own language. So I am in God synchronous orbit now. No maneuvers are required anymore as I am placed in my final position in eternity. Bas, that's all. This is all has to be done. And it is written on page 50, published. It is book written by both of us. I was assisting him. I did not realize that what he is writing. I thought aise likh rahe hain. And then within 25 of days, he is gone. Now the question comes, what is this? How can he say that 1 month before that this is it? He's not telling I will die. He says, I am established myself in the final position in eternity. That's all he's telling. He's not even using the word like moksha, life, death. He's not talking about, he's talking perfect scientific English. I am in God's synchronous orbit now. I have positioned myself in eternity. So I come to the second part of my presentation, in that Lord says in Bhagavad Gita, in whatever way you approach me, I will assist you. Some people wanted to come here, you were assisted. Some people don't want to come here, that is also okay. God ko koi problem nahi hai. Somebody want to go and watch a cinema, somebody want to go to Ganga Ghat, somebody want to do whatever they want to do. God is going to help you in every way. But at the end, whatever God wants only will happen. Okay. What does it mean? You are investing in a business, sir. He won't stop you in but that whether that business will be successful or not, that he will decide. So what we call failure in life, setbacks in life, wastage of life, is not in our failure to know what God wants. So how do I know what God wants? Now I'm introducing the concept of Sthitpragya. We call also is Sthitpragya. They are the two pronunciation. I am picking up because I am in Varanasi. I am picking Sthitpragya. Sir, in Vijayawada, I will say Sthitpragya because that is called like that. Now, the important thing is that there is only one God hidden in all beings, all pervading the inner soul of all beings, the ordainer of all deeds, who dwell in all beings, the witness, the knower, the only one, devoid of qualities. This is Svetashira Upanishad. Exactly this is what it is written. So God is not out there. God is very much here, inside. Okay. Agreed? Are you getting what I am trying to lead you? He is inside. He is not outside there. Outside also is there, but inside also is there. So would you prefer to talk to outside or you prefer to talk to inside? That's the issue. And on this particular shloka, there is no religious conflict. There is no religion which does not say that. So first of all, let it be very clear, that is not a religious discourse. This is it. This is accepted by every religion of the world. There is no confusion on this account. God is everywhere. There is nothing beyond God. There is nothing separate of God. Now, spend 5 minutes on this slide and life will be changed after that. See, each one of us, we daily experience three states. First state is the wakeful state. You and I are both in wakeful state now. Wakeful state means, in Bhagavad Gita, it's very nicely told, 19 doors ka ghar hai ye. But these 19 things are, 5 sense of perception, I can see, I can think, I can feel, 5 sense of perception, 5 organs of action, I can walk, I can move my hands, I can move objects, I can digest food, 5 kind of actions I can do. And then consciousness, then there are 5 vitals, my blood pressure is there, I am alive, my heart is beating, my brain is working. So this I operate through mind, intellect, ego. Mind is sitting here, you are planning our dinner milega, nahi milega. You bodily are here, but mind is somewhere else. Intellect is, what is this crap? Okay, I am pursuing my career in such and such branch, why do I hear all these things? Ego. And then intellect is, this is not my field. As if you are some Isaac Newton and some Lord Kelvin is talking to you. or some cardiologist is talking to you. This is not my field. So this is what we are. Each one of us is in waking state. We are somebody. We are not present where our body is present, and we are all suffering our intellect. I know everything, he does not know anything. I had a very interesting discussion, sir, Dr. K.P. Reddy, famous eye surgeon. I visited him with my son and my daughter-in-law, and he was sitting there, and he says, there was one more gentleman, and he says, the recent research says that out of every 5 human beings, one is schizophrenic. And then he says, is 5 of us are sitting in this room.
So, ek to hai.
Very nicely he explained. Then he says that schizophrenia is not that ek hai, char nahi hai. Schizophrenia is a matter of degree. And what he told, what is the first degree of schizophrenia? I know everything. This is the first degree of schizophrenia. You know everything. Fantastic. Second degree of, thoda advance hone ke baad, he does not know anything. Abhi apne se jade, now you have decided on another person also. He does not know anything. Aur thoda advance hone ke baad, nobody knows anything. Mere koi samajhta hi nahi hai. As if aap apne aap ko samajhte ho. Baki log bhi aapko nahi samajhte hain. And then it advances, and further you decide that whole creation is an illusion, and let me create my own reality. So that is how it is a matter of degree. All of us are schizophrenic. All of us. Mere bacche mere se pyar nahi karte. Aapne apne pitaji ko kitna pyar kara tha? No, that is a different issue. That was my father's problem. So tab father ki problem thi, ab bachon ki problem hai. Aap to innocent ho. So this is schizophrenia. Now, all of us sleep also. Now, the important point is, you exist during that sleep also. But what happened in that, 5 vitals are very much there, but your 5 senses of perception and 5 organs of actions, they are reversed. Now, you are sleeping and you are dreaming. I am in Bombay, Shri Devi has come and say, how are you? No. Kuch bhi ho sakta hai, dream mein toh. And then, you throw your hands also. दूसरा बताता है तू क्यों कूद गया खाट के ऊपर से नहीं मैं सोचा फुटबॉल खेल रहा हूँ सो देन व्हेन यू गेट डाउन देन यू गेट अप एंड यू से नहीं नहीं ये तो हॉस्टल ही है अभी इसमें फुटबॉल नहीं खेलना है सो दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंड इन द ड्रीम स्टेट एंड योर माइंड योर इंटेलेक्ट योर ईगो एवरीथिंग टर्न्स इनसाइड एंड क्रिएट ब्यूटिफुल ड्रीम वेरी फैंटास्टिक स्टोरीज विच इज नथिंग टू डू विद योर वेकिंग लाइफ सो दैट इज ऑल्सो रियल. Now you can say that is real or you can say this is real and both may be unreal also. We don't know actually. We very much exist when I'm sleeping. We very much exist when we are waking up. Now during the sleeping stage, there a lot of research has been done. I have a sleep lab in my hospital also. Little parts are there which are called dreamless sleep. In that, all this variety entertainment program also is stopped. You are just alive. Why you are alive? That means now in this stage, there is something beyond you which is operating on you. Which is keeping your heart pumping, which is keeping your food getting digested, which is keeping your blood pressure intact, temperature 98.4. Somebody is maintaining. Who is that? That is Pragya. That is the cosmic intelligence, which is keeping oxygen 21% in the atmosphere. आप कुछ भी कर लो, आप air को pollute तो कर सकते हो, उसके oxygen को कम नहीं कर सकते. That is keeping hydrogen and oxygen together as water molecules. That intelligence is also keeping you alive. Now if you can tap into that intelligence, you know everything. That is called Sthitpragya. When you anchor yourself into that cosmic intelligence, you know the whole code, you know the whole movie, you know the whole drama, you know what is to be done, and get up and do that, that's all. When Lord Krishna says, yudh karo, that's all. That is Sthitpragya. You have something from inside telling you, do this, and you do that, and that is called grace, and that is called transformation. cocoon will become butterfly. Caterpillar will become cocoon. Transformation. You don't remain same. You go into some other world. So that is the idea of Sthitpragya. Now where this pragya situated? So on that, Gaudapada is Adi Shankaracharya's teacher's teacher. His teacher's teacher. He has written that there is an empty space in heart. So my cardiologist friend did not contradict that. Heart mein char chamber hai, blood aata hai, pump karte hai, par empty space to hai. Agar empty space nahi hai, can that pump work? If there is no empty space in car, internal combustion engine, can it work? Pragya is that empty space. What a beautiful definition, what a beautiful concept. You say, this is my house. Sir, you are a builder. What is that house? That house is those, building is the house, land is the house, but the space where you live, who bought and who sold? But you exist in that space. That space is there, is everywhere. That is how God is everywhere. When you take a picture, you call, ye ghada hai. To us ghade ke andar kya hai? वो स्पेस है जिसको आप घड़ा बोलते हो. घड़े में पानी भर दो. कहाँ पानी भर दो? उस स्पेस के अंदर पानी भर दो. अब घड़ा फूट गया. दैट स्पेस डू नॉट एग्जिस्ट. सो वाटर आल्सो स्पिल्ड आउट. सो दिस इज प्रज्ञा. प्रज्ञा इज दैट इज एवरीवेयर. दैट इज प्रज्ञा. दैट एम्प्टी स्पेस इज प्रज्ञा. एंड हु इज स्थित प्रज्ञा? व्हेन ए मैन हैज गिवन अप द डिजायर्स ऑफ द हार्ट and is satisfied with the self, he will reach that highest stage. So desires are that noise which will not allow you to get into that stage. Jo bahut desire ke bundle hain, unko sapne hi aate rehte hain. 10 baje soyenge, 10 baj ke 20 minute pe Sri Devi will come. Utar sleep bhi nahi lagte because they are waiting to sleep. Now those who have less desires, their dreamless sleep is a little longer. And that is why they are healthy. That is why their body does not degenerate. They live long, they live healthy. What is diabetes? Your pancreas is telling you are a stupid fellow, I don't like you. I will not make insulin for you hereafter. Or jao jalebi khao. That is what is diabetes. No? Let us understand why my body is turning against me. What is autoimmune disorders? What is allergies? What is constipation? As simple as that. Because your intestine are telling, ye theek nahi kar rahe ho tum, ye theek kha nahi rahe ho. Uske baad bhi hum chalu rehte hain. Uske baad we go to very aggressive remedies like enema and all these things. Ye koi jeene ka tarika thodi hai. In cardiology, they put a catheter, they expand it, put a stent inside. That is not the way heart is to be repaired. Heart is to be repaired by looking into the matter. What is making my heart sick? Mera dil itna chota kya ho raha hai? Why I am so mean? Wo naav wala 500 rupaye mang raha hai, 2 ghante dhoop mein naav chalayega, apne muscle power use karega. Aap keh rahe ho 50 rupaye kam kar do. But you are not saying the same thing when you are sitting in a 5-star hotel. You are not saying same thing to Indigo flight. He is charging 10,000 rupees. Usse to kuch nahi keh rahe. Naav wale se chak maar rahe ho. So we are full of ourselves. Intellect, main to bahut intelligent hu. Or ego and mind. So you have to remove these three, then only you can plumb into Sthitpragya. Now, some characteristics have been defined. Whose mind is undisturbed in the midst of sorrows. Ab wo to student life mein to sorrow 50 tarah ke hote hain. Why exam hote hain, thesis likhi jati hai, aur bahut kuch hota hai. Examiner ajeeb ajeeb baatein poochta hai. Guide aise poochta hai jaise pehli baar mila hai. Tu kaun hai? Are? सर मैं आपका सेवक हूँ, दो साल से आपके साथ काम कर रहा हूँ. हु इज फ्री फ्रॉम डिजायर इन द मिडस्ट ऑफ प्लेजर्स. सब कुछ अच्छा चल रहा है और चाहिए, दे दिल मांगे मोर. अभी हो गया ना? नहीं, मेरा 9.5 जीपी आया. एक्चुअली आपके यहाँ 10 होता है 5 होता है? 10. तो 9.5 आया, उसका देखो 10 आ गया. अरे भैया उसका 10 आ गया, तुम्हारा 9.5 आ गया, आप क्या उसके बाद 9.5 से क्या करोगे जो 10 आने के बाद नहीं कर सकते? सो वी आर अननेसेसरली कंपेयर अवर सेल्फ इवन वैन वी आर गेटिंग एवरीथिंग. मेरा कम्प्लेक्शन अच्छा नहीं है, लेट मी बाई फेयर एंड लवली, उससे क्या हो जाएगा? कोई अपने बाल रंग रहा है, कुछ दिन बाद बाल खत्म ही हो जाते हैं, फिर क्या रंगेगा? सो वी आर ऑल वी फाइंड मीन्स एंड वेज टू बी अनहैप्पी. देन फ्रॉम हूम लॉन्गिंग फियर एंड रेथ हैव टोटली गॉन. वो किसी का इंतजार नहीं करता, किसी से डरता नहीं, किसी से घबराता नहीं. वो डॉक्टर कलाम मैडम इंदिरा गांधी को देख रहे थे, उसकी वैसी स्थिति हो जाती है. यू डोंट केयर अबाउट एनीथिंग. मोदी जाएंगे तो मैं क्या करूं? ये फ्रांस का प्रेसिडेंट भी आएगा तो मैं क्या करूं? वो जो नाव वाला है वो तो परेशान है कि मेरे को 20 किलोमीटर दूर भगा दिया जाएगा, जितनी देर मोदी जाएंगे मेरी नाव नहीं चलेगी. इज ए बॉदरेशन फॉर हिम, हिंड्रेंस इन हिज ऑक्यूपेशन. अनअटेस्ट इन ऑल कंडीशंस, अटेनिंग गुड और बैड, नाइदर डिलाइटेड बाई गुड फॉर्चून नॉट रिजेक्टेड बाई ट्रिबुलेशन. इफ यू सम हाउ स्टार्ट लुकिंग बिहेविंग लाइक दैट, देन योर ड्रीम्स विल कम डाउन, ड्रीमलेस स्लीप विल इंक्रीज, एंड यू विल बी मोर कनेक्टेड टू द कॉस्मिक इंटेलिजेंस, एंड देन योर इंट्यूशन एंड देन योर आइडियाज विल टेक यू समवेयर वेयर अदर मॉडल्स कैन नॉट गो. Now I come to last but one slide, and this is the most provocative slide. Isha Upanishad 12th shloka says, into binding darkness enter those who worship the unmanifest. There are some people who are guided by astrologer. Pandit ji bataiye kya hoga, Pandit ji kya bataye, Pandit ji ko apna nahi pata. Okay, so they wear तलिस्मान, देवियर, लाल वाली अंगूठी, नीली वाली अंगूठी, और ये वाला पत्थर, वो वाला पत्थर, तो वो जो अनमैनिफेस्टेड है उसमें डूबे रहते हैं. सो इनटू ब्लाइंडिंग डार्कनेस आर दीज पीपल हु ऑलवेज बॉदर्ड अबाउट जो सामने नहीं है. नहीं, कुछ तो होगा, कुछ तो होगा, माई लक विल चेंज. अरे कहाँ से चेंज होगा? बट द सेकेंड श्लोका, सेकेंड लाइन इज वेरी प्रोवोकेटिव. Into still darkness, greater darkness, as it were, those who delight in the manifest. मैं तो heart specialist हूँ, I'm the best cardiologist of this world. अरे heart को चलने के लिए बहुत सारी body की जरूरत पड़ती है, तू doctor है ढंग का नहीं, पहले ये बता. No, I am a greatest cardiologist. But mankind need a great doctor, noble doctor, not a great cardiologist. So some people they live in their specialization. That's all. In cardiologist also, I am the electrophysiologist. I am the interventional cardiologist. मैं neurosurgeon हूँ मगर I deal with the left brain. अरे ये क्या हो रहा है? So they are so many super specialists. All these super specialists, they delight in their own knowledge. Isha Upanishad says they go into deeper darkness. उनकी हालत और भी खराब है. So never be proud of your knowledge. Stay grounded. In your reality, whatever is to happen in your life will happen in this present moment. Attend to this present moment. Tone down your desires, tone down your vagaries of mind. Become a calm person. Enjoy, listen to the chirping of the birds, the star in the sky, moon. Kisi ko ye bhi nahi pata aajkal shukla paksh kaun sa hai, krishna paksh kaun sa hai. Time kiske paas hai moon dekhne ke liye? So just get connected with so many beautiful things are happening around you, and that is the stage of Sthitpragya. It is not some intellectual stage, it is the most real state which is keeping you alive, which is keeping you healthy, which is keeping you flourishing. If you are connected more with that, you will flourish. And then in this world, whatever best is there is all yours. So with this, I conclude this lecture. Guru Brahmo, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shuru Guruve Nama. If I don't sit in the feet of Dr. Kalam, I will not be able to give this lecture. Now, one last question I want to ask you, that during this last 45 minutes, 1 hour, did you feel the presence of Dr. Kalam? If yes, please raise your hands. So, thank you very much. God bless you.
So, thank you, Professor Tiwari. Like, maybe it had been, maybe in such a short time, you have given us experience of a long, long journey itself. Like, maybe what is that we were missing in our life and where is that we had to land. It was a great experience for all of us. Naturally, we are thrilled and there will be many, many questions in our mind. And Professor Tiwari is here to, yes, answer a few of the questions. Yes, sir. For your wonderful lecture itself, like Professor Tiwari. Now, I request our Honorable Director to do the honors to Professor Tiwari ji, please. Honorable Director, Professor Rajiv Sangalji, for his presidential remark. Professor Rajiv Sangalji.
I think the lecture took us through a journey. Journey with Dr. Kalam. And you rightfully said you have brought Dr. Kalam with you. Dr. Kalam, I met first in 1999, I think. There was this conference on natural language processing. And he had come, this was the dinner and the conference, and he came, this was in Chennai, and he told very clearly, he said, I want to be able to search in Tamil. I want to be able to type Tamil word and I should get all the documents in English, Tamil, any other language. And this was very inspiring for that conference. A lot of people worked on that problem. I think it was, and then he visited us in IIIT Hyderabad in 2003, and you had come with him, and I got introduced to you. And, you know, he had his way, his simplicity, how he dealt with people, high or low, he dealt with them at the same level. And I observed that every time I met him, whether outside Rashtrapati Bhavan or inside Rashtrapati Bhavan, you would have had many more experiences of observing that. You mentioned Dr. Radhakrishnan, and if you, for people here, Dr. Radhakrishnan was a Vice Chancellor of BHU, and there was a problem with the Indian ambassador in Moscow and the Russian government. And this Indian ambassador had spoiled all the relations with all the higher people in Moscow. Not country to country, but personal level. And nobody could fire her because she was the Prime Minister's sister, Vijayalakshmi Pandit. But when the Prime Minister, Nehruji, came to know, he said, well, we have to repair the situation. And he recalled her and asked Dr. Radhakrishnan to become the ambassador to Russia, Soviet Union. And there it is said that Stalin, who was the general secretary of the party and most powerful man, he refused to meet the Indian, new Indian ambassador, because the previous Indian ambassador he was very unhappy with. And after waiting for a few months, maybe 2-3 months, then he gave audience, said, all right, I will now meet the new Indian ambassador. And Radhakrishnan, it's a formal ceremony where he presented his credentials. And while doing so, he tapped Stalin on his cheek. Right? He touched Stalin's cheek. There was silence. Stalin's name itself, you know, caused fear in people. Stalin didn't say anything. The next day, it is said, he told people, there is at least one man who thinks I am a human being. I think Dr. Kalam would have done the same if he had been in that situation. He dealt with people as a human being. And to him, position did not matter. Power did not matter. Wealth did not matter. In your, I'm sure, while you are writing his autobiography or biography as co-author, you would have come across such instances. And the biography actually, I had already read the biography before I met you, and so had my entire family. In that biography, your incident of the NIMS is mentioned, that how your heart stopped and you were going to die, and then came out of it, and then came out of it permanently, or leaving that problem behind. We are all very thankful for that. Coming back to Dr. Kalam, I think he was a people's president. I think no other president, there have been good presidents, even great presidents, but no one like Dr. Kalam. He was a people's president, and he touched people, he met young people everywhere that he went. He thought about them, he talked to them, and everywhere he gave several messages, but one important message that he gave everywhere, which I think you have also given us, that young people should work for high aims. If you do not choose a high aim, you are not being fair to yourself, because you are capable of doing much more than what you are thinking. The misfortune today is that majority of young people are aiming very low, so they should aim high, and then they will do justice to themselves. With Dr. Kalam, I think it was you who, it was you who one day called me in Hyderabad and said in a very simple matter, I think this was in January of 2006, I don't remember the month. Sir, if you are going to be, I was director of IIIT Hyderabad. You said, if you are in Delhi, Dr. Kalam has asked me to convey a message to you. If you have time, please go and have tea with him. You said it in very simple words. And he wants to know what you are doing with human values. That was the time we had just started experimenting. But somehow the message reached him, and perhaps it was you who would have conveyed it. And sure enough, we prepared for that meeting and went there and met him. What was a half an hour or 15 minutes to half an hour meeting lasted for 2 hours. Because he wanted to know various details, various aspects. And then he said, I want to meet again. We had another meeting I think in June, and again that was a 2-hour long meeting. So, of course, after that he talked to the nation on this in his address on 14th August, evening of 14th August, message to the nation, he talked about this experiment. So, and of course, later meetings with him were always very inspiring. And the fact that he talked about and thought about how technology can touch the common man, and whether it was the space technology and titanium and how those things can come into the form of calipers or limbs, artificial limb, as well as a stent and whole lot of other things. So I think he was an inspiration for us, and you have brought him alive through your talk. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Rajiv Sangalji. In case this event could be held in this manner, there must have been certain people behind the whole show. It's our duty to thank each one of them. For this purpose, I call upon Professor K.K. Singhji. He will present vote of thanks.
Good evening. This is a really very wonderful evening that two great persons share their experiences. This lecture actually inspired each one of us, and myself also feeling that I am not nobody but somebody. I have seen Dr. Kalam at Bhabha Atomic Research Center at just 10 feet away. So window was open and he was just outside, means he was waving to people around the street. I was one of them. So we are really thankful to you, sir, for delivering this great lecture and accepting our invitation to coming over here. So thank you so much. I am thankful to Director, sir, who has always supported this ILS in big way. So thank you so much, sir. I am thankful to Professor R.S. Singh, Professor Agrawal, for conducting this ILS 32nd in the series. And most important, I am thankful to all of you who have come over here and attended the lecture. Thank you so much. And I request you, please have a cup of tea outside this hall.